Hi everyone. Next we are going to learn about periodic and non-periodic signal. In periodic and non-periodic signal, we can find out whatever the signal we are getting as input or output. Is it a periodic or non-periodic? Periodic means whatever the signal we are taking it as one whole signal. Like I'll take in one signal like this. This is one signal or one waveform. You can take it as one form, one signal. If it is repeating continuously throughout your full signal, then it is a periodic signal. After some time period, it is repeating its signal. Like if we are taking T naught and at T1, it is repeating its signal form. Okay, that is called as periodic. If it is not similar with the same waveform, then it is non-periodic signal. A signal is said to be periodic if it repeats after a fixed time period. If it is repeating after some fixed time period. Okay, given if I am taking an example as a signal of any signal with the value x of t. Take it as t, and this is a continuous signal. As I told you, you have two different type of signals, that is continuous and discrete. Continuous means you will be having continuity in the signal like this. Anyway, it can be sinusoidal, it can be any sweep signal like this, triangular signal, anything. These are the continuous signals. If I am taking x of t as a continuous signal, the signal will be periodic if x of t is equal to x of t plus t naught. T naught I can take it as a period. Okay, any interval t naught is next one time period. After this, if I am taking the shifting the signal towards one time period also, if this signal is equal to your x of t, whatever the input signal we are giving, then it is a periodic signal. Here one example they have taken, you can see here x of t is equal to a cos omega t. Okay, x of t is equal to a cos omega t. Here W will give you frequency, and frequency what you can write W as 2 pi f naught or f 2 pi f. Okay, this is wavelength, W is wavelength, f will get f is a frequency, 2 pi f is a frequency of the signal what you are taking it as x of t. A is your amplitude. How to measure the amplitude? You will be taking one signal means. From zero to highest value, from peak of the signal will be there, no? That will be your amplitude of signal. Okay. That is your A. Okay. And totally, if I am applying, what they are asking us, x of t should be equal to x of t plus t naught. Okay, now I am applying wherever t is there, simply replace t with t plus t naught. What we can do, x of t plus t naught is equal to a of a cos omega t plus t naught. That you can see, then you can I can continue with a cos. If I am multiplying W with t and t naught, you will get WT plus WT naught. Then a cos omega t plus 2 pi. Why I will get this 2 pi? because T naught is equal to 1 by F naught, and you can write that as OW is equal to 2 pi F naught. W naught, W will be equal to 2 pi F naught, and totally 2 pi is overall 180 degree shift. Then A cos WT plus 2 pi, 2 pi cos 2 pi, if we are taking dividing this, then cos omega T plus cos cos 2 pi you will get. 2 cos 2 pi value will be 0 here. That's why A cos omega T is your final answer. Then you can say that x of T is equal to x of T plus T naught. That's why the cos A cos omega T signal is a periodic signal. Okay. Cos signal you can write it as. This is a continuous periodic signal. That is an example related to periodic and non-periodic signal. Okay. And in the same periodic and non-periodic signals, a signal is said to be non-periodic if it does not repeat. And for non-periodic signal, always you can say periodic and non-periodic difference. You can tell x of t should not be equal to x of t plus t naught. Okay. A non-periodic signal is assumed to have a period of t is equal to infinity. Normally you can take that period as infinity, means continuously you will be having different signals only. There won't be any repeated signals. Example of non-periodic signal is an exponential signal. Like you can write an exponential signal in this way. Continuously it will be increasing or decreasing exponentially. Okay, this is an increasing. If I am taking a decreasing exponential signal, you can take it in this way. It doesn't have any periodicity because it will be continuously changing with respect to time. You can see with respect to different amount of time, the signal value will be varying. Okay, that's why it is called as non-periodic signal. One example also they have given. Periodic signal and aperiodic signal. Here it is a triangular, or you can take it as a sweep signal. Then it is an repeated signals are there. If I am considering this whole part, like this whole part, if I am taking, this is one signal and next continuity with the same amplitude and same signal with amount of time period we are getting it. That's why it is a periodic signal. Here you can see repetition of the signal is not there. Variation in the signal is there continuously. That's why it is an aperiodic signal. Scaling of signal. That is amplitude scale or scaling of signal. There are some important properties of signal such as amplitude scaling, time scaling and time shifting. Among these properties, now we are discussing about amplitude scaling. Consider a signal x of t which is multiplying by a constant a, and this can be indicated by the notation of x of t in terms of, you can see it, take it as I am discussing.